My name is Kathy Steece-Collier, and I am a professor in the Department of Translational Neuroscience at Michigan State University in the College of Human Medicine. I am studying ways to improve therapeutic treatment for the millions of people worldwide with Parkinson's disease. It's the second most common neurodegenerative disease. 1 in 100 people that are 60 have Parkinson's disease. Even though there are lots of therapeutics for people with Parkinson's disease, none of them are optimal. The brain's superpower is plasticity, so it can change in response to disease or other environmental factors. Some of that change is good, but over time, as the disease progresses, more and more changes occur, and the brain ends up getting what's called maladaptive plasticity, so changes in the brain that aren't so good. So I've been really interested in ways that we can prevent that maladaptive plasticity. And one of the things that we came upon was a little calcium channel that's located on a particular population of cells in a brain region called the striatum. So the area of the brain that dies off in Parkinson's is back in your midbrain. It's called the substantia nigra. Those neurons contain a chemical called dopamine. Those neurons send little projections up to the striatum. It's in the striatum where you don't get dopamine when those cells die off that these maladaptive changes occur. And a lot of them are related to overactivity of these calcium channels. Too much calcium is not good. You lose connections, you get all this miswiring going on. So we thought, if we can silence those calcium channels, can we prevent all of these maladaptive changes? So we take a inert, harmless virus, and we put genetic information into it, and we use that virus as a Trojan horse. The virus gets into the cells, it delivers some genetic information that says silence the production of those calcium channels. And we saw unprecedented prevention and reversal of severe dyskinetic behavior in these experimental models. Wouldn't it be wonderful if a person could take their medication and not develop side effects? Wouldn't it be wonderful if they could take their medication and know that it will work throughout the duration of their disease? Wouldn't it be wonderful if they knew that their disease wouldn't progress and perhaps even reverse the motor deficits without even taking medication? That's what we're seeing with this gene therapy. I'm fortunate to work with a team of incredibly talented women scientists. They have a variety of expertise. Together, our efforts are pushing this research towards making a difference in the lives of millions of people worldwide with Parkinson's disease.